I got this aloe vera from my garden, freshly plucked aloe vera, and I thought of making a soap out of it. This aloe vera gives radiance to the skin, removes the pigmentation, age spots. Pimple marks disappears by using aloe vera. So I thought I will use aloe vera, and along with that I'm also planning to mix pomegranate juice to make my organic soap. This pomegranate juice is very beneficial to the damaged skin due to sunburn and aging. It acts as an antioxidant also. So now I'm going to peel the aloe vera, take out the flesh gel and peel the pomegranate, and I'm going to mix both of them and take a juice out of it. This juice I will be mixing along with my caustic soda so that this aloe vera will reduce the effect of caustic soda. To make cold processed soap, we need oils like sunflower oil, coconut oil, olive oil, shea butter. It depends upon the skin. I have dry skin, so I would love to use olive oil, coconut oil, sunflower oil. Sunflower oil gives radiance to the skin, and coconut oil, it nourishes the skin. Shea butter, it also gives more moisture to our skin. So I wanted to blend all that. Sorry, I couldn't give the ratio because that's a secret what I'm using, and we need to blend the oil and make it more soft. Now the blending process is going on. Use a nice blender so that you use it only for soap making. This is kaolin clay. This kaolin clay powder acts as firmness to the skin. It is very useful to firm the skin. Also, it removes the clogness and pores from the skin. So I mix kaolin clay to thicken the soap. You need to blend it. Now I'm adding titanium dioxide powder. Even this powder is also very useful, and it also helps in brightening the skin. So if I blend this, my oil becomes a little bit, the oil color changes, so that we will get nice color to make our soap. This is caustic soda mixed with pomegranate and aloe vera juice. So I'm going to mix this caustic soda mixture to my oils. Should be very careful while handling, that's why I wear gloves, because if it splashes, we may lose our eyesight also. Also, it'll burn our skin. So that's the case, I mix aloe vera so that it'll reduce. So without mixing caustic soda, it's difficult to get the saponification. Okay, we got the texture, and you have to blend it very slowly, because too much if you blend, it will start thickening. After completing blending the mixture, I would like to separate into three portions. That is, one is red color and one is green and one in white color. Red in the sense of pomegranate, a green in the sense of aloe vera, the white is a soap base. So now I am mixing more of titanium dioxide again, so that I will get the white colored soap base. I am mixing some more titanium dioxide. According to the color, you need to check and mix it. Blend it slowly, you need to blend, because it will start thickening, it will become more hard. Then you cannot pour the soap mixture into your mold. You need to take care. And the process should be very quick. You should have all your things around you. Now I'm mixing primer to my soap base to make it more of a bright white color. Let's blend it. Watch the color. It's brightening. You can mix still more primer if you want more bright white color. Blend it. Meanwhile, you need to check your other two mugs so that it doesn't become more thick. Keep stirring often. Now see the color. You have got the bright white color. I am going to mix the essential oil. Whichever essential oil you like, you can mix. I have mixed a fruit punch, like watermelon, marshmallow mixed essential oil. It gives more exotic smell. Stir it gently. Sometimes if you mix essential oil, it may rise, because we have already added pomegranate, aloe vera, caustic soda. Sometimes the more you go organic, it may get risen or curdle. So you have to gradually add the essential oil. Meanwhile, I am stirring the other 2 cups of the soap base. Need to check it. Now let's pour the white soap base into our soap mold. I have a rectangular soap mold. It's very easy to remove it out also. Pour the soap batter into the mold. Cleanly you need to take it out. And now let's take the other soap mixture. I'm planning to mix the red color because my theme is pomegranate and aloe vera soap. You can mix essential oil to this red color soap base. Now I'm pouring the soap base onto the white. Wow, see the color. Now I'm going to take the string and mix it to get some kind of designs into it. Slowly you need to mix it. You may leave it like this, or you can go for a piping. Those who are new to it, just mix it and again add the soap base, white soap base, on top of it and cover it. New soap makers can just leave it. You need to tap the soap base so that to avoid the air bubbles inside. Maybe a small design like this for the newcomers. You can do this design and leave it. Wipe around and you may leave it. But I am planning to pipe. Do some piping design. So the other soap base is there. I am going to mix green color to make some leaf kind of design. Mix it accordingly the color which you plan for it. I am mixing in this lemongrass essential oil, which will give good fragrance to our soap. It depends. Some people are allergic to the essential oil, so you may not use the essential oil. But let it be. Again, blend it. Now the soap started thickening. But we may need this kind of thickening kind of soap paste to do the piping, because piping, if it is too watery, you cannot do it. I'm waiting for the red color also. Checking. Oh, slightly started rising. Slightly curdled. So my piping may not be very perfect. The more we go organic, we cannot expect our soap to be very smooth. But it's very beneficial. Okay, now I'm showing this piping, this kind of piping. I've used. Put it in a glass so that it is easy for you to pour the soap mixture into it. You can see the soap mixture slightly raised. Okay, this is for the leaf I've planned for the green color. Gradually you can drop this into the piping cover. And this is for the pomegranate seed. Side by side I want to. I don't know, see, we plan something and finally the soap
it will have its own design. So let's see how this design comes out. For icing, we need our cake rotating stand, that is for piping our soap. So I keep my soap mold on top of the rotating stand, which is easy for me to pipe. Now I'm going to start the leaf type piping. Whichever design is comfortable for you, you can do it. But see that you do it quickly, because the soap base will start thickening and it's difficult to pipe it once if it hardens. This red color I'm planning to make as a pomegranate flower type, and it's not coming properly because it started raising. As I said, the more organic we go, it's difficult to get the exact shape we wanted. And once if it is a handmade soap, doesn't matter, it to be very perfect. This is a kind of pomegranate on top of it I'm designing. You can design on your own, whichever you get to your mind. Whichever colors also you can plan on your own. The remaining green, again I'm just piping as a leaf on top of these flowers. Slightly it has curdled. What I expected, I couldn't get the smooth finishing. Now I'm just adding the glitters to it. Skin safe cosmetic it is, so no issues. We can decorate this to our soap. This is what I plan, and I have piped the flowers accordingly so that I have to cut it. So when you cut it 1 inch or 2 inches, you need to get 2 flowers. The remaining soap batter, I didn't want to waste it. So if you have any soap molds, you can just fill in your molds, so that you don't waste your mold. But be quick enough, because see, already it started hardening. So you have to quickly collect all your waste soap paste, whichever it is there. And again, this way you can form some other designs, any shape, whichever. If you don't have mold also, no problem, you can make into a small balls. Later you can use it as a rose petals. Now smoothen it with a spoon, but be sure you are very quick. See, again I had the leftover red color piping, so I'm just filling everything into this mold. Yes, my soap is ready now. Again, you have to tap it to remove the air bubbles inside, and make sure you wear your gloves. Finally, we have done with this soap. The soap has come out neatly. According to our theme, I plan for pomegranate and aloe vera. So this pomegranate seed, pomegranate flower, aloe vera in the sense of the leaf type, all that we have planned. So it's more organic. The more organic we go, it's very safe to our skin. You have to wait for another 24 hours to cut it. Well, next morning, I'm very happy to see my soap very neatly done, especially with this rectangular mold. See, very easy to remove it. So you need to expand the sides. Gently you have to remove it without breaking your designs, so that it will blob outside. Just look into the way I take it out. Wow! See, the soap base, very neatly it has come out. Of course, few areas, some kind of rough surface we can see. This is how I cut it.
with the help of knife or a soap cutter. Slowly you need to cut it. Beside, I have a soap cutter also, but many of you people will not have, so I'm teaching you in an easy method. If the surface is not neat, you can just cut it. I didn't want to waste my soap, because as I say, the more we go organic, the soap will be rough. So need not worry. If you want to sell to your customers, or if you want to gift it, you can do it this way. You can smooth all the sides, whereas I never do it. I just leave it with the rough surface, because handmade soaps, organic soaps, it will have its own natural shape. Now the other mold waste, soap paste, which I poured it into my mold. Wow, see this design, how it's come out. See the color of the soap. When we remove the soap, we need to wear our gloves, because the caustic effect will be there. Now the soap, I've kept it, we need to wait for 30 days to cure. Minimum we need 30 days for a soap to get cured. These soaps are very helpful for age defying, for spotless, brightening up the skin. Pomegranate, it helps in UVA and UVB, which is helpful for the photosensitive skin.
Hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching.